at that wand. It hums with inner source.
Thank you. You see a glimmer of hope flicker across Slane's eyes as he notices your approach. It's quickly doused with a practiced scowl of the oft disappointed.
Have you brought it? Or am I to remain a slave?
Slane rears back in eagerness, grasping the purging wand with razor-sharp claws. Before your eyes, the source from within the wand surges into his draconic form, filling him with a light so bright that you must shield your eyes from the glare. The blazing brightness dies down. Squinting, you now see no dragon before you, but the figure of a handsome lizard. A handsome lizard with the same eyes as Slane. His eyes still blaze, a piercing silver. A triumphant smile dominates his face as he bows extravagantly before you.
Slane. Against all odds, I am at your service. Neither. Both. I am a dragon knight, the last of my bloodline. Shifting between two shapes is our greatest gift. What I would have given to hear her death rattle! The memory of it would have lulled me to sleep for the remainder of my days. Knowing that vile woman rests in pieces gives me great comfort. I'd like to offer you the same. When you are truly at a loss, when you have no choice but to back down or perish, you will find safety in my shadow. This, I promise. This is an island of many mysteries, of many horrors. I'll learn what I can. Perhaps there is some possible reprieve for the souls who suffer here.
Slane smiles at you and turns to leave. He takes no more than a few steps before he shimmers out of lizard form, blurring in midair back into a majestic dragon that soars away.
Thank you.
You knock hard against the wood, searching for a hollow space or hidden lock. No matter where you look or touch, the door remains stuck.
I'd say we should stop to talk, but I'm swamped. Don't make much of it one way or the other, but the farther we get away from the joy, the better.
There's got to be a way off this island.
Sure thing, Chief. What's up? You know, wherever the next road leads, I guess. I never was one to sit in one place too long. How about you? You're missing home by now. I get you. So, what is it you miss exactly? I hear you. But it's kind of exciting, isn't it? Nothing lights my fire like the fear of mortal peril. Just me? No? Yeah? Never mind. But let me tell you something else. I've always kind of felt like home isn't really a place or a time or anything like that. It's just a feeling you get. It's all in the mind. As far as I'm concerned, whatever's going on in the old noodle is just as real as what happens outside of it. Which is why I'll feel like a bit of a stranger wherever I go, until I get rid of whatever's taking control of my beautiful brain. That does help. Thanks, Chief. Sure thing, Chief. What's up? Sure thing, Chief. What's up?
Such barbarism.
An old elf's pained gaze passes between the crucified. He seems on the brink of tears.
Mercy!
Dear ones, not like this. Not like this. Not like this. They're as good as my family. But I cannot heal them. I cannot heal them. So much pain. They are changed. That Dallas woman did something to their minds. They won't be moved and they can't be healed. They resist it at all costs. They can't even be healed. Using such magic on them would kill them now. Such beautiful souls, corrupted by such evil. Where you find shriekers, you can trust the Divine Order is hiding something they desperately want to keep private. Fate of my dear ones proves there must be some such thing on this very island. Stay away from shriekers if you want to live. I know not how much longer my friends here have.
This again. I found something. smoke, blood, and carnage. The Magisters didn't spare a single seeker. I've spotted something.
Here, look down those steps and tell me what you see. So you think those things down the steps there are dangerous? The ones hanging on the sticks? Want to go to the wharf, don't I? I'm a wharf rat. There's food and stuff on the wharf. Might even be a ship. I've always wanted to be a ship rat.
Its eyes narrow.
You want the food for yourself, don't you? I should have never said anything. I'm going to protect my food. Stay away from it, you.
Your eyes brim with inquiry, so ask.
Mercy!
I'll need to get clever with this lock.
You're stumbling away from the shoreline, a deep wound in your side. Behind you, the remains of your ship slip beneath the water. You press on, you and the others. A clearing further inland, a camp, a magister camp. They weren't supposed to be here, yet here they are, twice as many in number as you and my friends. You reach for your sword. But the sky is already thick with magister arrows.